Keysight's InfiniVision X-Series oscilloscope offer a broad range of application-specific licensed options to help you debug your automotive serial buses more efficiently, such as CAN, CAN-FD, SENT, LIN, and FlexRate. In this short video, I'll give a demonstration of performing an iDiagram mass test on the CAN-FD bus. iDiagram mass testing is an important test for many of today's higher speed buses, such as the new CAN-FD bus. So let's get started. Here we show an InfiniVision X-Series oscilloscope triggering on and decoding a differential CAN-FD bus. This bus has a base rate of 500 kilobits per second and an FD rate of 10 megabits per second. Now we can clearly see the FD fields here where you see the speed really kick up. Now we can zoom in on one particular frame, see it closer, or we can even zoom in closer to see just the FD bits where they begin to take off. Now this right here is the bitrate switch bit, and all the bits following it until you get to the CRC field are the FD bits. Now in this view of the waveform, we can see our amplitudes look pretty solid, not a lot of noise or ringing, but it's much more difficult to get information about the timing. Are these edges in the right location? That's where a CAN-FD iDiagram is really going to help us out. So let's go ahead and perform an iDiagram mass test. First, I'll insert my USB memory device that has stored copies of CAN-FD mass files that I downloaded from Keysight's website. Then I'll recall the appropriate mask file. There are a variety of mask files, some specifically for dominant bit low probing, some for dominant bit high probing, and then various FD baud rates. I'm probing dominant bit low, and I have a 10 megabit per second FD rate, so I'm going to select back that file. When you recall the file, the scope will automatically set itself up vertically, horizontally, and triggering, and overlay all dominant and recessive bits into what looks like an eye. And this is called an eye diagram. Now, CAN-FD eye diagram mass testing tests just the first 10 bits in the FD data phase, but it tests it of all CAN-FD frames from all nodes. 10 bits covers the worst case resynchronization time, which can happen if two consecutive stuffed bits occur. This will test for worst case clock stability and jitter over 10 bit periods. Overlaying just the first 10 bits of the FD data phase from all frames will show waveform characteristics of all FD bits from all nodes in the system. Let's now take a closer look at the mask itself. The mask defines a fail zone, which is shaded in gray here. This is the area on the scope's display where signals should not enter for this pass-fail eye test. The mask is based on a 6-point polygon, which is common for many of today's serial bus standards. The upper boundary is set at minus 0.5 volts, the lower boundary at minus 0.9 volts. Now this is for if you're probing to view dominant bit low. If I was probing to view dominant bit high, and I recalled that particular mask file, then it would be plus 0.5 to plus 0.9. The left point on the mask is set at 30% of a bit time, and the right point mask is set at 80% of a bit time. And a bit time in this case, since it's 10 megabits per second, is 100 nanoseconds. Now the sample point on most FD buses is typically somewhere above 50%. Where my mouse is pointing now is approximately 60%. Sometimes it's as high as 75%, which is at the apex of the polygon mask on that corner right there. And so that is why the mask is shifted to the right rather than right in the center of the screen. Let's now zoom back out and interpret what we're seeing here. In this particular CAN-FD iDiagram mask test, we can see that one of the system's nodes generates a recessive bit, which is high in this case, and it rings and dips down into our mask and violates it. So you can see where it's highlighted in red, indicating failures. This test reveals that there may be a risk that this dip in the differential signal from that particular node could be interpreted by other CAN FD transceivers as a dominant bit. We can also see that this CAN FD system generates approximately 20 to 25 nanoseconds of timing uncertainty or jitter. And if we look at the statistics here, we have a failure rate of about 1.7% after testing over 750,000 CAN FD bits. Now watch what happens if we add noise to this signal, which might be more typical of a real automotive system. You can see the eye is beginning to close, which means that we have a smaller valid data window. And it even begins with this ringing and dip, it begins to look like the eye is winking at us. Now to exit a CAN FD eye diagram mask test, all you have to do is press clear mask, and it goes back to the sequential timing mode that we were looking at before. To learn more about Keysight's and Finivision X-Series oscilloscopes and how they might be able to help you test and debug your automotive designs, contact a Keysight authorized distributor and ask for a demonstration. Thank you.